Good afternoon, everyone. Today is May 1st, 2013, and it's been a long time. I always say that. It's been a long time. But I'm going to go and take a jog, and I'll catch up with you later. And if those animals are out that I told you about, I've been waiting for the sunshine. It's gorgeous today, so we'll see how it goes if the animals are out, which there's a guy that owns some land with these gorgeous, gorgeous property and peacocks and whatnot, and I don't know if the peacocks are out right now, but we'll see. So I'm gonna go. It's about a three point something or other mile. It's been a while since I ran it. It's down a private road in the area that I live, so catch you later when I get back, sweaty and all. Okay, bye. Okay, this is part of the land I was telling you about, and up here I took a break. Let's go see what animals are out. I think at a distance I saw that there was some, what is that? I can't tell if that's a horse. I can't even tell what the heck that is. Looks like little pygmy goats or something. And I'm assuming that's what that is right there. I want to see what. Is that not freaking awesome? And you ought to hear him in the summer. Holy crow, I don't know if it's mating. I think if I'm quiet, you could probably hear them. Let me see how many I see. Goodness, I wish I could make this bigger, people. Dang it. I don't have a fancy camera. Shit. Shoot, sorry. Anyway, that's the beautiful green tail coming down on the one peacock. There's like three of them, I think. Huh. Okay, that's that. Back there, there's a horse, I believe. Anyway, maybe when I come back, I gotta get moving here, but I'll see what's out when I come back, okay? Bye. Okay, guys, other side of the road. Oh gosh, it's windy out. Hope you could hear me. There are donkeys, three, four. And again, that's part of that land that was back there where the peacocks are. That's the road that I came from. And I'll be going down this way with a big curve down the end. And that is that. Okie dokie, beautiful day on this May 1st, 2013. Yeah, beautiful. Bye everybody, I gotta get moving. Bye. 64, oh gosh. Hill, don't we love hills? Not. Another big hill around the corner. Okay. Okay. In a bit. Bye. Little alcove. The water is out. Look what I just found right here. Look. Somebody must have found a shell down there. Anyway, here's where I'm going. Up this next hill, guys. Okie dokie. That's the end of the road, cul-de-sac. Like, look at these beautiful flowers. These people live on the water and it's beautiful. Can't see the water beyond there, but it's gorgeous. Howdy, folks. I'm walking now. You know, I forgot to tell you, it's been a while since I've been making a video, but forgot to tell you that I've been doing Turbo Fire. I'm on the third week. That's Beachbody product. I'm not affiliated with them at all. But gosh darn it, I love the way it makes you feel. So anyway, I did, today was called Hit 20 Stretch 10, which basically means, HIT means it's high intensity. That's what the HIIT, high intensity training, I guess it means. And, what a kick butt. So I'm walking right now. I left my water at home. I debated if I wanted to bring it, so oh well, a lot of hill here. I want to turn my camera around for a minute. Anybody that's on the raw path like myself up here in the woods here, and turn you around for a second. Up here, there's a trail. And actually, if I look close enough, here, I'll show you. There is nettles. Look at all the nettles. Now, I wouldn't get the nettles here because they're against the road, but look at all the nettles. This is nothing but nettles. Now, again, I would never do anything with nettles here. However, if you go up in the path again, and you're probably saying, what do you do with nettles? I'm going to walk around this cul-de-sac thing, guys. Nettles are made, we love to make tea with them. We don't dry them first either. We just, I boil them. And then I like that, but not even boil them. I just roll the water. And probably for about 5 minutes, maybe 5-10 minutes. They're steeped in water, and just put it in the refrigerator. And if you feel like putting stevia or whatever in it, go ahead and put stevia in it. I don't, and my husband loves it. Actually, do we put stevia in it? I know I don't put any fake sugar in it. I don't put real sugar in it either, of course. It's really hard making a video when I have black-eyed peas in my ear. It's a beautiful day, as I said. How many times could I say that? But I hope I'm really not good at videoing myself, guys. We're coming up over a house here in a minute. Beautiful yard, and there's water out there. This house is so picky that they have poles out here that they want to watch what's going on this road. This road is freaking private. Unless you live down here, you don't come down here. A few blocks off from where I live, but their surveillance cameras are a little up the road here. They have a ton of acreage here, but I'm gonna turn the camera around and show you the water here real quick, right? Water. See the water out there? Pretty? Is it pretty? You know what? My best. Again, I hope I'm on camera. I don't want to screw this up. So anyway, I'm pretty beat. And I'm going to stick with my jog, walk, run outside. Looks like the sun's going to be here for the whole weekend. And between this and my turbo fire DVDs, I should be doing pretty good. Maybe doesn't know about turbo fire. It's 20 weeks. Here comes a car. So it's 20-week program. So when I go to Pennsylvania in mid-June, I already talked to my aunt. She's gonna let me use her house. She has a house that no one lives in it. Anyway, she has furniture and a refrigerator and a bed. So I get to go there and do my exercise instead of going to my aunt's house. So I'll be all by myself. I don't have to break my program. So I'm glad for that. Anyway, I'll let you go. I'm gonna try to make videos more often, guys. It benefits me, keeps me on track. Otherwise, if I don't do it, it's not that I don't. By the way, I haven't made videos for a while, but in the past, it's because I've been doing bad. I haven't done bad, I've done good. So, I think everybody's doing a restart. Whether you're juicing or eating regular, everybody's doing what makes them feel right at the moment. I think it's the weather in May, so I smell pretty flowers. Okay, I'll let you go. And put this together and it'll probably be up in the night. Bye. I don't know. Is that a mini pony right there on the right?
Yep.
A little donkey guy. Aw. Wish those peacocks would come back.
They're looking.
Hey, look who showed up. Talk.
Hi guys, it's me.
It's my husband. Look at this. Oh, smart Alec. Turn around, they probably couldn't read it. Big dog shirt. Hot dog, the brand with bite. Big dog sportswear ingredients. Quality, value, fun. Anyway, my husband.
It's hard work.
Yeah, he got home early, caught up with me. Darn it though, I wish those peacocks were out. All right, back there. I think it's because the guy showed up to feed them. All right.
Okay. Oh my goodness, I hope you guys can hear. There's some hound dogs behind my husband. But I want everybody to watch Dr. Oz tomorrow. What's tomorrow, May 2nd? Thursday. Guess who's on for you juicers out there? Joe Cross. Joe Cross is going to be on Dr. Oz tomorrow. So, and I'll tell you what, even if you guys are not juicers, why don't you set your VCR? Maybe if, I don't know if the guy's just going to have a small segment or if he's going to have 20 minutes of the show. So why don't you all watch it so you kind of learn what juicing's all about. Telling you, it makes you feel good, and don't knock it till you try it. Okay. No, you can turn it off now. Let's jog. All right, you can.
Don't you...
Okay, guys, workout done, as Jess would say.